I'm moving different. This shit ain't nothing to me, man.
Pulling out the hammer. No! Trying to make my spread.
Oh my.
Start breathing. Breath.
The Souls games have built a reputation over the years as being very difficult. This has not stopped players all around the world from finding ridiculous ways to increase the level of challenge. But I am by no means a good player at any of these games. Recently, the generational idea of trying to beat Elden Ring at level 1 dawned on me. Soul level 1 runs have become a staple of the From Software games, and Elden Ring has seen its fair share of these runs as well. I felt that this would be a doable challenge to start with, and also a great preparation for the DLC which is on the way. However, it's been 2 years since this game's release, and many of the tricks used in these runs have been patched out. So, the question is, if I use all the possible cheese and strategies available to me, can a player of my caliber complete a run like this?
Be kind to me, BBK. Be kind to me, Burger King. Oh, he was kind. Let's go. At BBK, have it your way. And we already got another flask. Oh, I almost got poisoned. Never mind, I did get poisoned.
Turn on my dominance. I must have turned on sock. I didn't ignore y'all today. There's no 2K, no nothing. Just sit here and sweat my sack off for coins.
I thought we were tired from 2K anyway, bro.
Oh, good. I think we're at the same wavelength.
Cause that shit, God.
That shit's bad. Now we're not, and that, you know it's bad when we complain, cause we're not the complain types. Oh, we have never once in our careers ever complained about 2K.
I've got the goods. I can die happily now. There we go. Big rat just ate my booty.
What?
You heard me, man.
What do you mean by that?
You got a little nibble.
He got a little nipple.
Time to show off Lord. What the prep time has gathered for me. First,
I load into a game. They got me in here with Joe Montana. So.
Radagon Sorcial.
Boom.
+5 to all the attributes I will need. To go ahead and slap this on. Now you might be thinking, a great sword, but trust the process. If I can fucking two-hand it. I just did like 300 damage, bro.
Oh my god, I have no option.
Alright, Roger, get his attention for me. Let's go. Oh yeah, that's a stagger.
Yeah, this one. Huh,
riposte that man.
Hey, brother, he pulled out the hammer. No, Roger.
Oh, Roger dodged that shit. Let's go, stagger again. Oh my god, we're actually violating, bro. Alright, I'm gonna back up. Roger, you should back up from the corner, bro. You're gonna get dogged upon. Roger's a little bit slow.
Yeah. Hey, Roger's good.
Roger has died.
Yeah. He won me, when I was first fighting a dude, Roger won. He gave me a dub like that. His stupidity won me the game. He gave his life for the cause. Like, he was about to, literally, Mark got to do a little jump attack at him, and he was about to kill him. And Roger just sat there. He just sat there, stone face statue, and summoned his sword. He summoned his sword and said, "Hey, I might be going out, but I'm leaving here with something." And he threw his last attack before that nigga died. And it was the one I needed to win. I said, "My Goat!
No!
His life for a good cause.
I soiled it.
Roger been sitting there for months, days, waiting till the day he killed this man. He been scouting it out.
No, he's already a half health now, though.
He been scouting it, he said.
There we go, got it.
Now I just wait for the... Now I just wait for a war, yeah, to help me.
Let's go, stagger. Oh. Let's go, Roger.
You're done, bro. Stop.
Good shit, Roger. Blast on him, blast on him. Oh, he just did a crazy...
He just did some crazy motion!
It's because of you. Y'all supposed to trade. Y'all supposed to trade distraction. Oh, Roger hit him, my turn. Then Roger be like, okay, you did that. Now he's walking up on you. I'll take a shot. And then Roger going to shoot him. And when Roger shoot him, he start looking at Roger again. That's when you come into play.
Facts.
But that's not the teamwork I'm seeing from the footage I'm watching right now.
You can't see this footage.
Not gonna.
He's pulling his cock out.
What?
That's another stagger.
I told him he needed to get that racism under control, man. You know what he said to me?
He said, hey, money.
Why would I take advice from a dirty tarnish like you when I said that's what I'm talking about right there?
That's the shit I'm talking about, man.
So then, I beat his ass.
Oh my God.
I looked at his lifeless dead body and said...
Boom! Got his ass. And the great sword was still in use. I never ran out of juice. I shall remember thee, tarnished. But you did, I bitch. Said, can I you said, believe this?
I told him, I want to get the next one.
Life like this sure is sweet, huh?
It definitely is.
Yeah, blow your horn, boy. You feeling horny. Got the key. No, he's locked me in. He's locked me in. All right, well, that's all I really needed.
I think he might have to go back to his comfort zone.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
And what might that be?
He been playing all these other games, and it just makes me uncomfortable. I'll do it later today. When I'll get you and Tyler on the 2K today, right? And call it my farewell tour, right?
We already at that point. We already at the farewell tour age.
Yep, we going on a 5-game win streak, and I'm calling it a farewell tour. And then I'm deleting it off my Xbox.
It's getting to dire times already.
It 'cause it's sad at this point. Like, you can't go out there and try nothing in this day and age, right? Like, damn, I want to try a new build. Can't do that.
Time to make my sprint.
Oh my god. Rainbow, can you hurry up and move to the storage car? I'm trying to go home to my comfort zone. Trying to get on Tekken.
They can't stop me.
Let me install my... It's over there. I'm going back to where I most feel comfortable.
Touch the grace. Let's go! Off me all you want now, blood. Oh, he didn't even get the chance. All right, Big Rick. Oh my god. Got Guy Rick to phase 2 already. And a stagger. Damn, alright. Well, that was actually a very good first attempt. I could probably kill him with this setup for sure.
But I don't know if I want to do that right now, so I'll probably stop here and consider getting the rotten stray ashes. And that's exactly what I did. So yeah, I picked up a couple things in the overworld, and I randomly happened to find the warrior's armor set in Kaled, so it was just me and Nefeli out here cooking Godric's old ass, you know, two warriors out here. But yeah, no, this fight was not bad at all. I think this was literally like the third attempt. And the Rotten Stray was plus zero, so he was actually not much of help at all, because he literally dies instantly. But don't worry, he will be of much greater use later on in this run once I get into plus two. And not even much later on, you know. And he's kind of an early game beast, helps a lot with Ranni's questline as well. But yeah, this ended up just being me and Nefeli cooking Godric. And it's honestly crazy because the Greatsword was not even part of my initial strategy. I just thought it would be funny to see a level 1 running around wielding a Greatsword. It also means, you know, you only get 3 minutes to kill each boss, so you really gotta get in there, help do some damage. You can't just stay back. And honestly, it made the early game a lot of fun. So, Godric, not too bad at all. Both bosses so far had been, like, you know, single-digit attempts, and that was a trend that I hoped to keep up throughout the early game. But also, we're going to be talking about a couple strategies that I had pre-planned here, a couple items that I needed to gather. So first thing, obviously, we want to get our bell bearings. You know, upgrade materials are going to be very useful. Get all the smithing stones, all that type of stuff. And but right here, I'm getting an important Ash of War, which is Crag Blade. You can find this right by the impassable Great Bridge, right by, you know, Radahn's castle. And that's going to be used on the weapon I'm wielding in this fight right here, the Heavy Iron Balls, which you get from killing Boggart. And these surprisingly, this weapon does insane damage with the charged attacks, the jump attacks. And then right here, I was just getting a solid summon in Lutel for later, and as well as the Academy Glintstone Keys.
Same day we did the Fodge. I was really having a good day out there because I think I had a whole bunch of points because like before we went there to go meet with them or just whatever, me and Anthony came up there with you. Yeah. Or whoever it was, so it might have just been me. I don't know. It was either just me or me and Anthony. It was 2 days like that. But you said we ain't gotta go for like 30 minutes. You had me out there doing straight shooting drills before the session. I went out there and just couldn't miss a jumper. I was like, hey yo, what the lab then done?
The lab is something beautiful, man.
Smacking everything I wanted. I just finally opened the YouTube channel doing decent. I just opened up fixing our farm records on channel, bro. I got 312.
But I totally forgot. 312. I saw that shit crazy earlier. Yeah, it was popping. I almost put a comment for my second channel.
Y'all suck.
Y'all suck. That's what I do. Dude, I be good at your videos. I don't even watch my click. I see it's uploaded. You'll see my comment like uploaded 3 seconds ago. You'll see me 5 seconds later. You trash. I ain't even watched it yet. But I already knew what happened.
Look at this shit. I can't even see this man when he moves. And then he starts breathing fucking breath out at me.
Yeah. I just don't get how we can send that off to the post though. And then they always fail too, and it just throws me back in this. Like, we thought I was just some soft guy, you was gonna take the post, and you lost. You lost the post game. Like, the dude at the Y who made one post layup on me and started showboating and said, you small. I was like, yeah, I mean, we do got a 4'8 height difference. God. I am 5'10, you are 6'5. I mean, I think your post can make that layup. When I first got y'all on there, I was like, come on, let's go to this area. And then y'all was sitting there like, this area is like, why everybody's like level 30? We are level 10s. I said, nah, y'all worried too much. I was in here at level 5.
No, I know.
It was a struggle.
Because you went everywhere. It was a struggle. Right off the bat.
I didn't know there was a path to follow. I was just running around. I didn't even have my horse when I was sprinting. I was running.
And God, that first 2.5 hours. Anybody can go with it. Part- if this part of the recording makes it to the YouTube video, I want everybody to go to Dohan Plays and watch his first 2 hours. I think everybody over here might just be poverty.
he just died.
How'd you know?
Because I know the sound of trash talking before death. I've seen it. I've witnessed it and been a part of it many times.
I've been a part of it myself.
All right, come on, Loretta. I need you to come out to your pond. I gotta treat Loretta like the duck.
Gotta treat Loretta like the duck.
Oh my god, it's actually gonna be wicked, bro. This,
if I could walk in the room, they'd be like, here's a dungeon. There's something secret here. I'll punch a wall. If I didn't see the answer to the dungeon by me punching a wall, I left the dungeon. I said, well, I'm out of here.
Bro, I've just been running around. Like, I got the Dectus Medallion and shit. I literally have 10 health flasks. And I have beaten Godric and Margit.
No boss.
And a bunch of side bosses.
I have no outsiders for a reason.
Heal up, Big Lance. No, stop the cap. Alright. Let me actually equip it to my hotbar this time. So I can actually get some heavy attacks off. You know what? The recording is at 30 minutes. I'm just gonna pause it because I'm just gonna bang my head against this wall. Till I win.
I encourage you to be great.
See, I turn off the recording and I win in like 10 minutes tops. Oh, what's good, Ranni?
Come on, baby. I told you I love me some blue girls.
Oh, God.
That's the first thing I said when I walked in. That's the first thing I said when I walked in.
And I ain't talking about Avatar.
What was Fia's ending? What was her shit was?
It's like the Age of Darkness or something. I don't even know.
Oh. Sluts always trying to destroy shit.
Okay.
I can contain it.
Alexander has kids.
I kept him in cold blood, and I went to the cup shrine. It was the whole. It looked like two baby little jars just sitting there talking.
Yo,
to me. It was
oh
like.
My.
It was two baby jars. And it was like, our dad Alexander went on a trip. He'll be back soon. He wanted to discover himself. I was like,
yeah, he'll be back.
He'll be right back. Mm, yes.
I yes, walked yes. away. I was like,
That's pretty juicy. So's his health. Okay, he literally one taps me.
I might need my Opaline bubble tier. I might need to get my free hit tier.
That's gotta stop
for
me, though.
Toe for toe! Bring Derrick Henry in. Let's run this rock a bit. What's your defensive stability? No superstar abilities on D. Oh, run that ball down his throat. Just jam it in.
Do not reach. I'm really bringing the ball in.
Boom! What did you do to stop me from jamming it in?
Not make it take it? So mad.
Look, he couldn't stop me. I started ramming it in there. He couldn't do nothing to defend it. So.
You said what?
Ram
in it.
I want you to know, I just killed a boss while you said that, so that's permanently on your record now.
Think about it. My record hasn't been clean. My gameplay record hasn't been clean in months, ages.
Attention, all maidenless tarnished. The great Kenneth Hyde needs your help to reclaim his fort from the evil knight commander that invaded from Stormvale. But to do this,
okay,
what he's gonna need is a reward to give you. Mm. All you need to provide him is, well, a few things. Your credit card number.
Yep.
Don't forget the three digits on the back. And
say less.
Expiration within a year. But you gotta make it quick.
Yep.
Otherwise, you'll lose your chance at becoming Elden Lord.
And lose my chance.
You don't have the right.
My bad, y'all. So I was just trying to figure out a better way to beat this shit. So let me just get up my credit card info real quick. Alright, let's see how this goes. I'm gonna need this while they get his attention. Alright, he's already rotted. Time for the shitty attacks. I need to be at full health all the time, or else I will get fucking clapped by some of this bigger shit. Nice. He's gonna take off for us. And then we're just gonna ride around. Oh, the rot ran out. Alright, we're just gonna try to reapply rot then. Cool. Alright, he should die to rot now. Let's go. That's why the rune arc was necessary, because then he can just die to rot. The summons did stay alive a good amount there. Oh, zoom in on the pantsless wonder. Hold on. Stop my thought process in its tracks. All right, but yeah, the fucking level one build is cracked. I don't know what to tell you guys. So we're going to go down to Nokron right now. Nokron? Nokron? Whatever the fuck. You guys get it. Okay, blood. You wanna be a nuisance? We can do that. I got iron balls. This weapon is actually so cracked. Like, you get this shit in Liurnia. You could get this before killing anything. You have to kill Boggart, sadly, because he's a pretty cool guy, you know. He's a real G. It's either this one. Oh, there they are. Yep. Oh, speaking of glove wart. Guess I didn't need to blast. He's a complete joke, and I'm gonna treat him as such. You trying to be me? My dog can deal with you. This is my day one right here. I jumped Ranala with this man.
Flashback.
Yeah, come on, Ranala. Fight back. Fight back. She can't fight back. She's getting cooked. She's getting cooked. Look at this. The staggers are too elite. My dog is too elite. I don't even care. I'm running straight in on this shit. You can't kill me. You trash. You trash.
End of flashback.
All right, let's watch the Battle of the Ages. The dog should proc rot. Yeah. Bro is rotted in 3 hits. The dog is about to cook this dude. Trying to be me. He could never be me. He could never be the pantsless wonder. You just a wannabe. 2 damage per hit. Alright, good job, buddy. Let me give you a little pet. Well, like I thought, the Carrion Inverted Tower was the bane of my fucking existence. But, hey. I forget which talisman this is. I think it's the Ent Talisman. Yeah, so we got the Ent Talisman. We got the Curse. Whatever the fuck it's called. I did lose every piece of money known to me, but it's okay because I didn't really need that shit, you know. It's a level one run, we don't need the money.
Stop the cap.
Look at my character bugging out. What's going on with bro? Calm down, pantsless wonder.
Later.
Alright, so before this video gets too outrageously long, we're gonna do kind of a rapid fire round here. If you're curious about how the rest of Liurnia went, Radagon was a complete joke, and obviously you saw what the Ranala fight looked like. But I did spin the block on this guy right here. We're gonna need the, what's it called, the tier? Yeah, the tier from him. So the Cerulean hidden tier should pop up on the screen in a second, but this is going to be very useful to summon any summons that the level 1 doesn't have the proper FP for. But now we're all the way up to the Draconic Tree Sentinel already, and yeah, you can completely cheese this guy if you didn't know. You can sneak around him on the sides. A lot of people like will use like Assassin's Gambit or something like that to stay hidden, but literally I didn't even do that. I just walked up, bro turned to stare at me, and then he stopped and went back after I stopped moving. But yeah, you can just hit him with poisonous mist while crouched and hiding behind him, and he will literally just sit there and die. You have to reapply it takes a long time, but luckily I was just spending my time listening to the new Metro Boomin and Future album during this fight, so the time went by pretty quick. You know, had to hear some bangers, and yes, this video probably will come out a lot later than that album, but just know that's kind of the timeline of these recordings. But you see, I was feeling confident going into the capital. You see my run right there, and then I had a surprising win. So there's two boss kills in this. I mean, it works well with the pacing of the video. Neither of these bosses I was actually recording, so sadly no live reactions, but I went straight to Godfrey. Didn't even have my things set up properly to be able to summon Lutel, which was going to be my summon for this part of the game. So I just ran in there, fought Godfrey normally. This was the second try, because first try I got brutally murdered. But yeah, second try, I surprised myself. Maybe listening to that Future album was really had me feeling some type of way. But yeah, you see, I almost died from his full stomp attack. I probably should have died, but I didn't. And then I hit this knight with the damn, must have been the wind. But yeah, then right back to Ronnie's questline. This is going to also be important to get Black Knife Tiche later on, which is going to carry the late game, hopefully. But yeah, this was honestly harder than either of the bosses that we have just detailed here. The Baleful Shadow, you can't summon in there. Bro has a lot of attacks that could one-shot me, and I didn't want to waste my rune arcs on him. So eventually I just figured out I can kill him with Bloodhound's Finesse. But yeah, definitely was more of a challenge. That dialogue was not lying. And then it was straight off to Estelle. I actually summoned Lutel this time, but I had no upgraded weapons that could actually hit Bro in the head. So I decided on the Reduvia. You get this outside of Patch's cave, so I was ahead of that way anyway to get the Margit Shackle, which I also didn't end up using, but the side effect was to get the Reduvia, which I do end up upgrading more and using more in other boss fights later on. But yeah, my goal here was to use Rotten Breath and then just get a bunch of bleed procs, as many as I can. This clip doesn't actually show the bleed procs because it was like the very end of the fight, but yeah. Got him low, the Ash of War carried, and then Lutel does the last hit there. You know, if the bosses aren't one-shotting with most of their attacks, and the summons live the whole time, it's never too bad. But yeah, Estelle and the little Baleful Shadow actually took more attempts than both of these two bosses. Morgott and the Shade of Godfrey, aka the Piss Goblin himself. But yeah, Morgott, once again, started off the fight, ran in there. Didn't even have my proper setup on, didn't even have Margit Shackle in my hotbar. Ran in there, hit him with the Rotten Breath, summoned Lutel, summoned Melina, and just dogged him first try. And I was very surprised. You know, this usually before I turn on my recording, I do some warm-up attempts so I don't look like a complete buffoon when I'm actually recording. But yeah, I just, you know, had the decently upgraded Iron Balls, got in there, did some damage myself, let the summons carry their weight, and I'm pretty sure everybody lived the whole fight, so honestly, not too bad of a fight at all. It kind of makes me wonder, should I have not summoned Melina for this fight? But hey, this is a level 1 run at the end of the day. I did say everything's fair game, you know, just trying to see how, you know, effortless can I make this run? And it's still not effortless, you know, a lot of challenging fights here, especially coming into the late game. But Morgott was not one of them, so yeah, he got murked, I can't even lie. Rotten Breath is just super overpowered. But yeah, now that we're in Mountaintops, I can finally get into Volcano Manor. I had to kill this guy with the bleed whips, and he is very difficult because he just Bloodhound steps around everywhere, dodges a lot of my attacks. But once again, Rotten Breath comes in clutch here. You can definitely Scarlet Rot this dude, and then it will stun him, so if you're far enough away, you can get some free damage in there. But this all leads to me being able to pick up another important weapon for the late game, which is the Serpent Hunter. You can take it out of the arena, never fight Rykard, and just move on with your life. But yeah, that pretty much wraps up this portion of the game. Had to hurry up and get some rapid fire moments in here, because otherwise this video will get way too long. But you know, just me and the Noble Gold Mask chilling here. Take your son to work day was looking real crazy. Oh shit. But yeah, Tisha's already putting in work, so we're gonna go back to two-handing this. I just sold. I should have stayed on the horse.
Oh my god, I should have stayed on the horse, bro.
Stagger, ankle breaker. Call me Kyrie Irving. I whiffed it. Well, not as clean as last time. If I would have actually just won last time, it would have been a very clean victory. But that's okay. Can we get out of this corner, please? I don't like him over here. Right by the fog gate is so lame. Oh, let's go. Stagger number two. Let's go. Alright, this should take us to phase two. Maybe. Alright. Let's try this shit again. Oh, he's not supposed to do that. Okay, well, he still did that shit anyway. Alright, I want to be full health to see if I can hopefully tank a fireball. I guess we could just do this. I don't think I can do it from the horse. But we're just going to see if Tish can solo this phase. Sorry to say it. Sorry to say it, I don't want to deal with bro in phase two. As you can see, she's doing a very good job. Yeah, she's gonna get it done. Plus 9 Tish to fire giant is OD. This is what I should have done last time, just stay on the horse. It was a fluke that he lived the first time, let's be honest. Bro was not supposed to live the first time. Bro got blessed by a roll into an attack that I was not prepped for. It was still user error at the end of the day. But yeah. As a level 1, I will do everything in my power to make winning a breeze. You see, the Pantsless Wonder build is complete. It is a generational build that has given me plus 10 all attributes. I'm in strong use of the Elden Ring wiki throughout this run because I have to find a lot of things. A cardinal sin. Oh yeah. Well. I'm ready. No, I definitely did let this play through on my OG run. When I was a filthy little mage. Still learning the world of the FromSoft games. But look at me now. And now we slumped up. Time to take a vacation to Ohio. Now I'm gonna let this guy kill me because I just want to sit at the grace, and I already touched the grace, so he can kill me all he want now.
That's a slide number 12.
You might be
not an open slide number 13. Now for my 15 slides, man. You never know how many shows I'm gonna watch tonight. Watch
tonight.
Two episodes of this, watch two episodes of that. This is what I have open. I have Welcome to NHK, Fighting Spirit, Poki Kaido Girls Are Super Adorable, Monster, Goblin Slayer, The Foolish Angel Dances with the Demon, and now I'm open to another one. Never know, man. You never know.
How many does one Kuda need?
You'd be astonished.
What happened to Jamaica? Not Jamaica.
That's where Tyler was born.
I'm sir. Yeah. Oh, I know that.
100% Jamaican.
How about you play that? How about you play them little bongos from the
You're
right
making
now?
Me feel some like, type of way.
How about I play with your little bongos?
Huh?
I've been had.
They've had me.
I've been had.
Please get stuck on your pillow.
I'm a...
There you go.
Yeah, this thing is slow.
Damn!
Bro, the summons are actually cooking, though. That shit's tough.
I'm trying to summon that meat.
Wait. Let me heal y'all.
Wait, healing summons?
Yep. Damn it, I'm out of juice.
What has the world come to?
Crazy. Here. There's what nothing outside the door.
Oh, I forgot about his signature move.
Signature move.
Yeah, man. My summons are still living.
Are they?
Yeah. I just first tried the foreskin duo.
I have a fast travel board unlocked.
Now, did I get carried by Rotten Breath and Bernal? Yes. But did I win? Also, yes. So what's more important? That's what I think we should ask ourselves.
But what does that have to do with him?
No. He's got a point.
Wait, what was the term I used earlier? See, now I already forgot. See, y'all cursing my vocabulary by hating on it.
Holy crazy. Illegitimate.
Oh yeah. See, I was gonna beat these guys by illegitimate means, but instead I just beat them with summons. Straight up. So they said we're bringing two of us to fight one of you. I said one of me.
You must not know.
Some of you guys might be asking, how did you even manage to get Teesh? Isn't the boss like super tanky and also the same type of enemy as Teesh? And yes, this boss is ridiculously hard, but luckily you can break its AI. I had to dabble in the dark arts. I looked up on YouTube if there's any boss cheese of this, and there was. So if you're lucky, you can run directly to the left at the start of this fight and he'll follow, get stuck in between this rock right here, and then you can literally just hit him. Almost 18,000 health this guy has, but yeah, if you can cheese the AI like that, it's a free dub, and then yeah, you get Teesh. What? So they're telling me that I'm running in a straight line, and I get thrown off the platform to the left. That's what they're telling me. I have to run past the birds again. Oh, bro, this shit is diabolical in nature. This shit is harder than the bosses themselves, bro. Like, they should be.
You want
damn!
That's okay. Almost as bad as you say, bro.
Well, let's just say that second phase attempt was short-lived.
What are you talking about?
I keep forgetting that's a whole explosion attack. Alright, this will not be too bad to beat. I'm not gonna lie.
Hey, you know what? I got something to say to y'all. Come here,
nigga.
I knew y'all was a bitch, nigga. Like, let's take this here for a sample. He the hoest nigga I know. That's why when I call him a bitch, he ain't gonna say shit. Bitch ass dude. See? He knew not to say nothing.
Dude. One tap is all I can acquire. Did you just say that and kick him? Did you just say that and kick him out the party?
He knew better to say something back to me, man. You see?
Did you just knew better. Did he just get kicked again?
He did.
Are you kicking this man out of your own party?
He knew better than
what?
Okay, that's the last one. If he comes back, I'm done. And see. See?
You cooked
sometimes
it.
Sometimes Cretans don't.
You see, cooked some it. Cretans he doesn't want to come back now.
Some Cretans know their place.
Much, much later.
Daniel! He wasn't supposed to react that quickly. Damn. Alright, well, phase one needs to be way cleaner. Yo! I forgot I have to go behind him. That did not hit me, bro. Bro did a casual swipe past my body and they were like, yeah. Yeah.
You're done, buddy.
Jump for me. Alright, we're gonna see how this goes. Oh my god, I routed him. This could be it. Hit him, Tish. Yes, got his attention. Oh my god, that's all it takes, bro.
Dude, like...
just made it easy. If it's just... I'm just playing the RNG roulette with it, though. If Tish spams her Black Flame Blade... and I get rot off in both phases, it's like the health bar just melts. I mean, it is probably the most luck-based fight with the strategy I was using. But yeah, I didn't end up using the Reduvia. I could have, though. That was the initial goal, was to just go for bleed procs, but that's not what ended up happening. All right, boom. 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 Oh yeah, I might as well put this to 24 while I'm here. And then we go. Boom. Boom. Hey, if y'all know, y'all know. I'm a motherfucking stoner. I got a motherfucking boner. Ah, I knew you'd come.
I knew you'd come to stand before the Elden Ring. To become Elden Lord. What a sad state of affairs. I commend your spirit, but alas...
Tish, finish the job. Finish the job, Tish. God damn it. Look at this buff. Oh, bro. Finish the job, Tish. Okay, I mean, I did get greedy. I didn't know he had already reactivated his explosive spell. But come on, like, she just stands there. Now I have to deal with his whole thing, bro. Like, no free heavies. Now it's gonna take 37 attempts, bro. Activate his bomb for me. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Let me get to full. I think this should be a victory. Yeah. The Black Flame debuff actually did its thing that time. I got a little more aggressive myself. Took way too many tries, bro. Not gonna lie. Let me pick up my zero runes. You know, I don't care about those runes. I'm not gonna use any of these runes, bro. Like, the build is done. Who knows? I don't even know if I can tank anything. All I know is... this could get real diabolical real quick. A long while. Oh, look at his dead body. Look at the dried out raisin. Like his body would still be there after that long. That shit would be nothing but dust on the ground as long as it took me to get back here. No, it hasn't been hasn't been that long. If we're talking about my first playthrough, definitely bro's body would have been decomposed by then. Okay, my stamina. Why did it take him that long to transition? Like, I was gonna heal, but I was like, okay, I could just probably hit him twice, right? I'm dead.
Well, phase one is gonna be easy. Phase two is what it's gonna come down to. You see Tisha's already pretty low. Let's go. Oh, he start. Why'd he start so far away? Alright, let's go, Tish. I believe in you. Tish is dead already. There's no way I was escaping that anyway. He does a couple other random things while I'm running around. Tisha's still at solid health. And then he's gonna do his big slam right here. But... So if you're out of range of this, you are still in range to hit him with Rotten Breath, which is perfect. He did run up on me and hit me because I committed to the full Rotten Breath, but I back rolled out of that. And then he went straight into this, so I didn't have time to heal, had to dodge it. Boom, dodge number one. And then I was prepped, dodge number two. And then now I'm able to go back to full. And then now I'm looking at his health. Just have to run around until the rot does the rest. Because Tisha did him with like three different black flame hits at this point. So I knew this was the one. So yeah, I just ran around. After I dodged the big attack in phase two, I knew I was going to get the dub. And that's exactly what I did. So solid win right there.
Your pancakes is dropped.
What the fuck is he talking about?
Now there's one last thing I need to do before we go do final boss attempts. You know, as the future president of this land, it's only right that I help out the citizens here, so. Time to go cure cancer, baby. I just want to cure her real quick. Yeah, bro. I'm a great president, trust. I'm a great Elden Lord. Oh, my bad. Yeah.
Oh, no. You killed her! God damn it! How could this happen?
Don't worry, she's fine. Alright, before I do the final boss, I need my inspiration. So let me turn on Ride the Boogie.
And we can ride the boogie!
Oh, I'm a
put him back in!
Like Mario Kart 06.
Dude, okay.
I played WWE 04. I played NASCAR. I think it was NASCAR 08. I had everything.
NASCAR 08. Damn, that's a one shot. All right.
Oh, and it's
oh, he went for the Kraken Slammer.
What?
Hey, fuck, bro. Fuck.
Okay, so.
Dude, 85 dude, post control. Dude.
Okay, I'll take the interior. So I can't even. I can't even really guard the paint, bro. Either.
Dude, Radagon got me pissing down my leg every fight. That's a good window right there.
Yeah, that was not a good window. It's just sadness to my heart. So listen, what happened is, my mom was telling me how I was evil since I was a kid, because I am a petty nigga. To this day, I'm a petty nigga. If you do something wicked, wicked, I will hold that grudge for a long ass time. You gotta do something diabolical for me to hold it, though. If I'm holding a grudge, you've done something deserving of me to beat your ass, and I just let it slide, because I should have beat the fuck out you. But I hold my composure, and now I'm just petty. And you should be happy that I'm petty, because I could beat the fuck out you.
Hold on, everybody remain calm. I just beat phase one, and I got 6 health flasks.
Okay, okay, we looking good,
Let me run next to the Elden Beast Coochie.
Okay. Okay, brother.
Oh, yeah.
I heard Lucas over there screaming. Like he don't got 6 whole flasks.
It's only 5 now, man. It's only 5.
You know, he gonna feel hurt because all us Elden Ring players agree. All Dark Souls, it don't matter what it is, Sekiro or whatever. We all agree. If you die with a flash, bro, that's just like...
Oh, yeah, that's the worst.
More than anything. That's the worst. Pain, like, bro. I remember I died with like 4 flasks. I almost started crying. I was like, nigga, I had 4 flasks, bro. I was still good to fight, but like... Because he did one attack that like took my whole full health bar, and I was like, bro, what? No, it wasn't one. He hit me with like a 2-piece. It was one, and then I tried to roll, and the second one just like clipped me barely, and it did enough damage to kill me. I was like, oh my god, nigga. This is not real.
Oh, the fucking wall. The fucking wall is here! No, I was going to win!
No, you did not just die with flask. Don't say it so. Laugh and get over it. All I...
Oh, you probably... Yeah. And that's a one shot.
Day 2.
Cast sprint up to him. Sprint up to him.
I nigga said that. Shoot. That nigga said, who called him? He was so quick.
This is not Leah.
Huh?
That's Leah, oh god. Why are you faking like he?
Yeah, this is not her.
This just hang up, dickhead. Oh, that computer thing is not going to listen to anything you're talking about.
I know, speaking of English.
Nah, he tries to switch it. Like you just say, this is not Leah in English twice. Nigga said this is not Leah twice. She kept going.
Speak English.
She said, we're here to confirm with you, Leah. I was like,
I don't give a fuck what you're trying to say, bro.
And she just kept going. I'm with it out of bounds, but I don't fuck with this nigga.
Bro, Radagon is breaking my game, bro. Bro did a Kraken Slammer into a leap attack, and the game just started moving in slow motion, bro. He did too much for them to handle at once.
He said, ha ha ha!
This is even to my full potential. And I saw that this was that they made a motherfucking live action.
I'm not locked on.
Dora.
Oh yeah, they made a movie. You ain't know that?
How did that even kill me? I was already sprinting.
I just saw that when I walked out. When I walked in and out there, and I was like, there's no fucking way there is a Dora movie. Live action.
That been
existing. It's getting out of control.
I mean, nobody watched it.
It was comp, man.
Nobody watches live action anything. Then they start trying to make live action of cartoons and let cartoons stay cartoons. Yeah, no, that's my savings.
That's what I'm saying.
This imp is just selling me.
Oh yeah, A is to call doubles.
If that's on me, that's.
Oh. I used to cut those, okay.
Yep. Hey, get that.
She didn't even try to get her. Oh, my. Give me that.
Boom!
Damn.
I don't think I had power.
I was trying to kick something wicked. Out of bounds, my ball. Oh. Get it out. Oh.
I didn't put no power in it though. Alright, so you really, the button press is specific.
Yeah, you gotta literally like just tap that whole.
Hold on, hold on, this should be it. Don't choke Lens. Oh, he did another melee attack, this should be it. Shoot. Jump attack, boom. Slap him, let's go! That's it.
I was about to thread that needle.
That's the level one run, baby. It only took me, 3 hours of recording for just the final boss alone? Like, come on now, man. You know I'm the greatest ever.
Come on.
And I got y'all moaning in my ear when I win. You know that's going on the video now.
Okay.
Yeah, hold on. Don't pan the camera though. Don't pan the camera to the best build in the game. Oh my god. Nah, if that ain't the drippiest fit you've ever seen, I just don't know what it is, man. Shit went